Contrary to popular belief, I've always been natural. My mom hated her perm, and therefore we never got one, my sister and I. But the older I got, the more I was allowed to straighten my hair, and you just couldn't tell me I wasn't fancy. I know when I started doing pageants here at Howard University, I was told that I should take on a more conservative look. But I had to challenge that thought. Why was it that when I stepped into formal or more professional settings, my hair seemed to be unwelcome? Well, last fall, I took on the ultimate challenge. I made myself wear an afro in the Miss HBCU competition. Out of all of the 32 contestants, I was the only one to do so, but I can say honestly, I felt like myself. And I think the judges might have been able to read my confidence. So throughout the year, I tried out different hairstyles. Some were kind of wild, some a little more conservative, big shapes, updos, all of which I documented through photo booth, of course, and found that when I was able to understand and appreciate myself, others were able to do the same. I loved the effect it had on me and on the people around me, and found that my natural hair was an expression of who I am and who I want to be. So I continued to push myself to be the person and the role model that I would have wanted to see as a little girl. Someone who knew that African hair and crowns could be worn upon the same head. When I visited schools, I wore my hair out so girls could see that they didn't need to be altered in order to be a queen. In fact, the way they were made them more so like a queen than any feature. Throughout my year as Miss Howard University, I learned that my truest crown was my birthday suit.